come under the BJP's policy, not only Tripura, any part of the country cannot be transformed to any progressive end. Of course, definitely, if any regime comes, some transformation is there. That is the backward transformation. In Tripura also now, during the regime of the left, what the common people are enjoying the fruits of the democratic, the establishment, democratic programs. Now, one by one, everything is being destroyed. Even now there, the onslaught has reaching to such extent, the very civil right, right to speech, right to demonstrate, right to oppose, everything has been being snatching away. That is kind of a dictatorship is going on there in the state of Tripura. Except the BJP, no other political party, not only the left alone, of course left is the foremost target, even other political parties, the Congress also they are being targeted. And within the BJP, their ally is the local regional party, IPFT. Even their followers also being targeted, wherever they are not abiding by to the that kind of the dictatorship of the BJP goons. These are happening. So, of course, it is only 7 months. One may the raise the question that within 7 months, how you can evaluate the performance of a government. But within 7 months, what Tripura is witnessing today in the field of its economy, in the field of its functioning of any other government department, and in the field of the exercise of the democratic rights of the people. Recently, you know, after this government came, they have forcibly compelled more than 4,000 elected three-tier panchayat members to tender their resignation. And after that, they have conducted the by-election of those the vacancies have been made. There, other than the BJP, no other candidates, no talk of the left, even the independent were not allowed to submit their nominations. In 96% of the total seats where the by-election was conducted, BJP candidates were allowed unopposed without an election. Even there in some places, not in all places, the ally of the BJP IPFT government, the IPFT supporter, they tried to put up their candidates there. They also attacked by the BJP goons. And that attack, not only attack, the brutal, fierce fight between the two factions. So the transformation in the state of Tripura, 7 months is because governments are elected for 5 years, 60 months. 7 months is the time, legitimate time for evaluation. But within 7 months, what we are witnessing today, we are very much afraid that what rest 53 months Tripura will see. So this kind of transformation is going on in the state of Tripura. CPIM, we believe in the democratic movement, we believe in the constitution. So we are trying to mobilize our supporters, we are trying to mobilize the common people. We are resorting to the protest against this kind of the gundaism. Though we are very much under attack, every day our people are shedding blood. Every day our party offices and houses of individuals of our supporter, it is being vandalized, attacked, or forcibly occupied. And there are attacks in many other ways, even though we have not stopped our activities. And we believe, we have the confidence that once people will realize. Today the BJP, not only by the support of their antisocials, even by paralyzing the role of law, the police, administration, everything got paralyzed. So the police and administration are not reacting upon, but definitely they will not also keep mum like this forever. And we are very much confident enough that earlier also in 1988-1992 under the Congress party, same thing they did, and now again it is being repeated, and same Congress people now they are in the BJP. So the players are the same. Name of the party is different, but players are the same people. They are the anti-left, anti-democratic force. And that time also, lot of people, more than 300 people were killed. More than 330 altogether during that 5 years of Congress, IPA, Tuesday's rule in between 1988-1992, the caused the martyrdom. So now again, once again, we are facing this onslaught, and we are very much confident that Tripura people will restore the democracy, and we'll again see how the democratic system is restored in the state of Tripura. Actually, Modi government, since its installation, within BJP also, Modi is something different. Because this government, though the tactically it is a BJP government, it is not a BJP government, it is a Modi government. So however, the Modi is the head of the affairs. Under his leadership, any government, any institutions is running. We have seen in during his tenure in as chief minister in Gujarat, what he did, the Gudara and so many things, how he manipulated the police force, manipulated the administration, how the IAS officers, the IPS officers, only those loyal officers, they are brought in the helm of the affairs. So same that experience of the Gujarat model, it is being now leveled in the Delhi. From Delhi also, the same the Gujarat model is going to be implemented. And now, definitely, India, for the time being, people may be little relaxed, people may be little, due to our common people is very simple. They may have some excuse to, that is BJP. But in long run, they will not do. And what the, in this case of CBI, happened this and Modi toppled the CBI chief, and they are not only the in the CBI, in the RBI, in the CBI, in the Supreme Court, in many places there are complaints from the different quarters that how this government trying to undermine, how to manipulate, how to misuse this. And there are from in between, from inside also, resistance are there, we are witnessing. And people will not take it granted for long that Modi will be allowed to run its, this kind of the monopoly, this kind of the dictatorship. And days are coming that people take the its own course. India now, the what else, the need of the hour is that every common citizen, every common people, they rise in the occasion, forgetting their flag, color, caste, creed, because democracy is in peril. once the democracy, the constitution, it is thwarted, its rule has been undermined, then everything has gone. As an individual, in the society, in the family, you can live in peace. And there as a common people, whatever your profession, you can't also sustain yourself. So that's why now time has come and people also, that is rising on the occasion, we are witnessing that very recently we have witnessed under the call of the Kisan Sabha, Khet Mazdoor Union and CITU on 9th August, the day of the Quit India Movement, how the more than 5.5 lakhs people, they participate in the jailbreak action against the Modi government. Again, on 5th September, we have witnessed there in Delhi, defying all the weather fury, that more than 1.5 lakhs people gathered there from across the country, including the women. And the central trade unions of our country, they have given a call for the 2 days bond. It is unprecedented in the history of the India's independence that the working people, the peasantry, they're coming forward in big number. So that is the symptom that people are not keeping silent and they're taking their own course.